Good morning.
Blocked the sun with my head. So this woke me up, and I just want to share it quick before I lose it. So you know, I love spectrums. I like to go down onto the spectrums and see what the sides are saying. You might see hummingbirds, they're all around me, but I'm scaring them away from one of their feeders. They have plenty to choose from. But one of my favorite ones is the religion spectrum. And so I listen to tons of atheists. A lot of atheists feel that religion is the cause of wars. And because they're looking at, you know, what they're looking at. So there's so much to look at, right? And then like Christians and stuff, they're looking at the inherent nature of man. Like they, a lot of them feel that man needs religion to be a good person. And that, so there's fear on both sides. So the problem is always fear. Fear is on both sides. But I do want to go over something really quickly, because I think it answers a lot of what I do. All right, so in the Bible it says man's made in the image and likeness of God, and I believe that has to do with the divine spark of consciousness that we have. Okay, so it's the divine spark of consciousness, creativity. Now there's a group of people that follow the what some religious people call little g God, and that has to do with Satan. And with, so Lucifer fell, and they follow that, and there's no creationary aspect in Lucifer / Satan from Saturday Night Live skit with Dana Carvey. And so the human beings who follow that little g God are manipulated. This is not me. This is, you see him? Do you see him? Manipulated into using their divine spark of consciousness, their creativity, to manifest evil things or bad things or bad behavior, non-loving behavior. Okay. So that's why Christians, that, you know, people who use the Bible and, you know, put that big G God, you know, at the forefront of their life. I know that for a lot of people who are spiritual, those people, those Christian people, can look fearful, like they're clinging to the Bible, as if they're afraid that without the Bible they could go astray. And there's a lot of things, if you listen to them speak, if you listen to anybody's heart and you can really understand where they're coming from, it will make sense. You may not agree with it, but I mean, you'd understand where they're coming from. And that's what I love to do. It's so neat. But anyway, what I want to say is, basically, if it's true that every human being has a divine spark of consciousness in them, which is their capability, their gives them the ability to create. Okay, so I talk about the divine spark of consciousness in every human being, and that's your creative aspect. So in the Bible where it says we are made in the image and likeness of God, the big G God is the Bible God. So it's the Jesus God. And you know, I had to learn why, you know, if Jesus was just a teacher, you know, why is Jesus God, Lord? And the way I understand it, and I could be wrong, but the way I understand it is there's the little g God and then there's the big G God. And Jesus only stands in front of the doorway to the big G God. So in order not to get confused, if you just look for Jesus, or you call to Jesus, or you, pray to Jesus, I guess, then you know you're getting the big G God. And so I say, highest and holiest source creator God, that can only be the big G God, the Jesus God. And I don't consider myself a religious person. I consider myself a spiritual person. But what is the difference, right? Whatever feeds you spiritually is your religion. And, I think it's funny that that these people asked me to be a minister, and I became a minister, and I'm like, well, that's funny. But then I was like, oh my gosh, I do these live streams every Sunday night at 9 p.m. It's sort of for like an hour, 15 minutes, sort of like a church service. Anyway, okay. So what I do with my divine spark of consciousness is I use the renegade yogi principles, and I just take care of my little corner of the world. So from my little corner of the world, I bless, I forgive, I respect the free will choices of, and I love everyone. And then I free myself up not to love their non-loving behavior. So that's what I'm doing with my corner of the world. Now, when I do that with my corner of the world, loving people live in a loving world. If you know about the law of attraction, the center of the vortex. So if I'm just being pure love, like I call it in alignment with my spirit, my spirit-directed life. So when I allow my spirit to guide my heart, but other people, so my husband's got a cousin who named Lola, which is like the coolest name, and she's very devout Catholic, so she knows the Bible inside and out. And she and I have just an amazing relationship. So she knows the Bible inside and out, but she gets to where I am with my four principles using the Bible, and she really is that loving a person, but she uses the Bible to practice her four, the renegade yogi principles. And she's just given me just fantastic advice a couple times when I've really been like, you know what? I'm just gonna dislike this one person. This one time, I'm just not gonna, I'm just not gonna love this one person this one time. And Lola's having to be there to like pick me up and say, you know what? You can do this. And so it's been really cool and helpful to have someone like that. So I really don't care if somebody's, Christian or atheist, however they arrive at it. And I bless and forgive the way anybody lives their life. But with my divine spark of consciousness, my little piece of creativity that I just have, I know that I have it because of what I've created already. So I know that I'm a creator. I know that I can create. I've created crap for myself, and I've created really cool stuff for myself. So I know I'm a creator just by my experience. So with my divine spark of consciousness, my little creativity, that I have, I've done a very nice job with my little corner of the universe. And so I don't know how deep I want to go here, but like, scaring the hummingbirds away. I don't know how deep I want to go here, but like, what are you doing with your corner of the universe, do you want to create a peaceful, loving world? Then you create it in your corner of the universe. I create it in my corner of the universe, and whoever else wants to do that has the free will choice to do so. And then, before you know it, it could be that if over 51%, 51% of human race does a nice job with their little corner of the universe, then we would see the world we all think we want. whether we have religion, spirituality, or whatever it is, it doesn't mean that I don't, I do pay attention. It doesn't mean that I don't, that I negate any of the horrific events happening. It's just that I only have control over my little corner of the universe. And then there are other divine sparks that they, using their divine spark, create a powerful thing somewhere else. Like people that I know really helped out the Rwandans, and one's from California, and then another one is from Newtown, Connecticut, and they've made a significant impact on people in Rwanda. Two human beings, one from California, United States, one from Newtown, Connecticut, have made a significant impact on people in Rwanda. So, anyway, the thing is, I love you. And I just want to know, what do you want to do with your corner? Your little tiny corner of the universe. What are you going to do with your divine spark? I believe that practicing the principles makes it easy for me to do a nice job with my little corner of the universe and to walk around and have a high vibration and, you know, affect other people positively. I can't tell you, like, I see people, there's no other way to say it, but I see people creating shit for themselves because they don't realize that they have this little powerful spark of creativity, this divine spark of creator in them, you know? And, you know, whether it's your religion that gives that spark a clear path of what to create in love and peacefulness, like Lola uses the Bible. I guess I'm too lazy to read the Bible. anyway, oh, and I do understand now too. I learned through my learning, looking at people, you know, on the religious spectrum. I'm gonna tap this out because clearly there's some crap to clear here. But I didn't understand why I triggered some really religious people when I said I talk about angels, that I talk to angels. And now I understand. But the thing is, for me, I've been able to hear angels since I was tiny, tiny little girl. And so I've just always sort of felt loved from, you know, spiritually. I've never felt alone. And the things that I hear helped me so much be more loving. Everything they ever told me helped me be more loving. But I do understand now why really religious people were freaked out by me. So, but I do always stay in the center of the big, huge white spotlight of God, big G God, the, you know, highest and holiest source creator energy. And when I say it like that, big white spotlight of divine, highest, holiest source creator energy, the creator part is the big G God, because the little G God does not create. So hopefully people understand that and feel it's covered. But like at the work I do, I never leave this big white spotlight and the protection of the highest and holiest source creator energy. And they get a lot of work done through that. And I create like a really nice life for myself and my family. I'm happy with it. anyway, I love you guys and I hope this helps at all. But just think about your little corner of the universe. That's all you have. You just sweep out your corner. You sweep out your corner, and how do you want to decorate it? Love, peace, light. That's your corner of the universe. And you do, you know, your thing with that. It was so much more powerful when I had my eyes closed and like I was downloading it. But I love you guys, and I hope you understand. I don't want to make this any longer. Have a great day. Create the most amazing day with your divine sparks. Use your divine spark of consciousness, you know, to create. Stay in the center of your vortex and just create just beauty for yourself and love for yourself. And the more you can create for you, the bigger you can get. The higher your vibration gets, the lighter your vibration gets, the more powerful you get, the more in alignment you get with the highest, holiest source creator. The more in alignment you get with that, then the more you can create. So the higher your vibration, remember, one person vibrating at 1,000 raises the vibration of, I forget, 250 million people vibrating at 200. I mean, that is so significant. So please, please, love the crap out of yourself. Love your body. Be grateful for your body. I love you, my beautiful body. Your body hears everything you say. I love you, my beautiful face, when you wash your face. Oh, you see him? Oh, he left. I love you, my beautiful face. I love you, my hair. You know, tell your body, oh, I love you, my beautiful body. Just create beautiful things for yourself. You deserve it. And the world needs you to. So, no pressure.